Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming. What a beautiful night. This is an awesome venue. Would be nice to be in our auditorium, but I think this is a pretty good alternative. So again, thank you and welcome to our spring concert 2021. One more time for the Fife Corps. If you're not aware, that ensemble is 100% student-led and student-run. Mr. Moran and I, unless there's a problem, don't help them out at all. That is all them. So before the strings get started, I just wanted to point out that the program, you can find it online. Mr. Moran and Ms. Valpato both emailed it out. Also, you can go on the Freedom Band Facebook page. That is facebook.com/8band, I believe. And the program is digitally on there. So, time for strings. Let's keep it rolling. A piece called Kinetic Energy. Our next piece is a student chosen piece. I had never heard this piece before, but apparently it's very well known. This is called River Flows. A River Flows in You. So Jasmine recommended this and I arranged it for the group. So enjoy. So again, that was the string ensemble, last names A through L. Up next is the other half, M through Z. So you will notice strings need to tune a lot indoors and especially outdoors. So please bear with us as we tune in between each number, or else it can get kind of rough with the sun and the heat. String ensemble M through Z will also be playing two pieces. The first piece is called Ancient Airs. It's just a fun little piece, nothing too special about it. But our second piece, this is the first time in my career here at Freedom High School that we are performing a student written piece. So the second piece was written by one of our seniors and arranged by her and one of our juniors, and she'll talk about that.
Kayla Wooden, and I'm a senior at Freedom High School, and I have been performing with the orchestra for 4 years. For the past 8 years, I have been composing Sweet Grandpa, which is dedicated to my grandpa, Peter Santani. In 2012, he passed away, and in fifth grade, I composed a theme and variation, then received 3 awards from the PTA Reflections. Throughout my high school years, I've decided to compose it for a string ensemble. There are 2 more variations to the suite, including those 2, which were too long. The theme represents my grandpa's life, overcoming through childhood, hard childhood, teenage years, delivering diamonds to Japanese soldiers during World War II, and then meeting my grandma, and then having a wonderful family. Then in the first variation called Walk Into a Ballroom Class, where it represents him teaching ballroom dancing and being the high school principal of my mom's high school. The second variation ends for now with a perfect couple variation sounding just like Grandpa's life theme, which represents him meeting my grandma, and it will start out nice and soothing and maybe an argument at the end. I hope you all enjoy it.
Thank you.
5 minutes as we switch for my favorite, jazz band. Thank you. my favorite pieces called Rule to Roost. You heard Adam on guitar. Alec on trumpet. Of course. On the drum set. Give it up for him. Tyler. Our next piece is called Dat Dare. This is going to feature John on trumpet and Ryan on alto sax. Just want to point out, we've had maybe 10 rehearsals. Somax starts this. Thank you. And the jazz band's got one more tune for you. It is our tradition here at Freedom, as long as I've been running the jazz band, to run a vocalist. A little more than a year ago, Connor made his debut with this jazz band. And today he sings for the first time this year and the last time this year with this jazz band, Connor Sternberg. This is Orange Colored Sky. Pretty good timing. Give us just a couple minutes as we reset for the next group.
Good evening and welcome to the bell choir portion of the concert. I'm excited tonight to have with us Amanda Kajawa, an alum, Freedom High School. She wrote a piece last year, our second piece, Minecraft, and it never got to be performed. So we brought her back tonight to hear it for the first time and to congratulate her and thank her for her hard work. The first student that I'm aware of that has written a bell choir piece, not an easy task. So let's give her a preliminary round of applause and congratulate her. We'll begin tonight with Amazing Grace, and then our second piece will be Amanda's Minecraft piece. The bell choir did not start together until February. They've only had about 8 or 9 rehearsals, and most of them are new ringers this year. Not an easy task. So we hope you enjoy what they've prepared for you, and we're grateful to be here in this beautiful weather tonight. Enjoy.
Thank you.
what do you do when you can't sing for 3 months, right?
Actually, you guys really did an awesome job on it. I'm so proud of you. If you only knew how hard it was for us to get that together with 70 people. They've worked really hard on many different things during that time that we couldn't sing. Rhythm was one of the skill building things that we worked on, and we wanted to share a little bit of that with you. As we move on into our next piece, Turn the World Around. This was originally written by Harry Belafonte, and it's the theme of our concert tonight. Turn the world around, and the many ways we can do that coming out of this world that has been so crazy for all of us. How awesome that we can sit here together on the lawn tonight and watch the amazing work of our students. That in and of itself is awesome. So this theme, and not just multicultural, but the theme of turning the world around, about who we are and our times of hardship and kind of overcoming that. And the lyrics in this song, we come from the fire, we come from the mountain, we come from the fountain. All of us coming together from physically difficult places, emotionally difficult places, to discover who we are and to make a difference in our world. Turn the world around. our cozy. Our next piece, Be Like the Bird, features our soprano and alto ensemble. And it was composed by Abby Bettinas, composed just after she completed cancer treatment for the second time. She sent this out as a Christmas card to her family. It's also dedicated to the High Rocks for Girls School, which focuses on inspiring, empowering young women, and letting them know that they have wings to fly and to rise above whatever is before them. Be like the bird. Only got to sing together twice before doing that. The whole choir has only sung twice together, so pretty exciting. Our next song, Paisé Café, is a Haitian folk song that tells the story of a young boy sent to market with coffee for sale, and somehow he loses the coffee on the way. What will he say to his mother when he returns home? He tries to retrieve the coffee in the marketplace, and where then he is questioned, his actions are questioned. Did he lose it? Did he steal it? Where did it come? Very grateful to one of our Haitian students, Casey Robertson, who was instrumental in helping us out with the Haitian on this and with some of the Haitian phrases that you will hear in the chaos in the marketplace.
Café, mamãe, foi super tight. Uma vez, café, mamãe, foi super tight. Uma vez, café, mamãe, foi super tight. Uma vez, café, mamãe, foi super tight.
acknowledge our percussionist, Sophia Trembler, and our percussionists on the last piece, Delana Loudenslager, Marion Keller, and Owen DiNapoli Anacharico. Thank you, percussionists. Nice work. It's at this time that we would like to honor our seniors. They have had a challenging 2 years with many disappointments. We are super grateful that graduation is a go, and we will be together and celebrating that. And I am here tonight to celebrate them and our last concert together. Our next piece chosen by them is called The Climb. It represents the battles that they have overcome over the last 2 years to get here, missing events like homecoming and things like that, but embracing the time that we have right now and the new doors that are going to be open to them as they receive their diplomas in June. We wish them the best of luck, and they will all be very much missed next year. Sorry, that was a little emotional. There's a lot in that. Our next piece features the Les Chanteurs, and it's our Beatles tune, reminding us we all have friends and loved ones around us in times of struggle. There are people to help us get our feet back on the ground.
Thank you.
Sanders, our soloist.
Excuse me, is Drew Harvey's parents here at the moment? Drew Harvey's parents?
student director, Katie Harper. Puffinist, Julia Root. And on bass, Jordan Shames and Tyler Maletsky. Let's give our rhythm section a round of applause. So as not to lose the feel of the end of our last two songs, I'm going to just take a moment. Mr. Moran will be doing some congratulations and thank yous to the many, many people at the end of the concert that have helped us out. But I'd like to take a moment to acknowledge our FHSV MPO parent officers, Sarah Facity, Lisa Kirby, Lisa Kemp, and Sandy Wilcox for their incredible work this year and keeping us going. This time I'd also like to acknowledge our student directors and our officers and section leaders. Our student directors, Katie Harper, Michaela Wilcox of Les Chanteurs, and Isabella Barbaris, our student director of the Chorale. Please give them a round of applause. Our student officers, President Anna Facity, Vice President Cadence McKay, Secretary Nicole Rosario, and Treasurer Isabella Barbaris. Let's give them a big round of applause. Section leader this year has sort of morphed into ever who could step up to the plate as we navigated these crazy waters. So all those of you who have helped out as section leaders, will you please raise your hand and be acknowledged? Because many of you have done that in different capacities throughout the year. Thank you so much for all that you have done as parents to assist the choir in moving forward. And thank you to all of you for your energy and your dedication, staying with it even through the times that we couldn't sing. Throughout the struggles of our past year, the pandemic has hit our children probably the hardest of anyone. Them not knowing what to expect, us as parents and guardians not even knowing how to guide them or what to tell them, because we've never done it ourselves before, we have no experience. Not that your parents have no experience, I'm not saying that. Do not quote that. But our peace prayer for the children was selected by Adam Walker, and the words in this really demonstrate our hope for them in the future as they come out of this and figure out what life is really like as they're maturing and growing. This features our M through Z choir. And our last piece, because we're going to roll through the two of those together, we would like to dedicate our final selection of CC Nimoja, We Are One, to Mr. Laporta. I'm not sure if he's still able to be here tonight. If he is, if he would be standing and recognized. Mr. Laporta has shown a steadfast dedication to our Freedom family and to supporting our students, our staff, and our community, and treating us all as one and helping us all to work together. This song is dedicated to you, Mr. Laporta, and we wish you the best of luck in your retirement. We are grateful for you helping us realize we are one family. We stand together, we stand strong, and with that we can rise above any circumstances. We wish you the best of luck in your retirement and in your future. enjoy the rest of the concert.
I'm back. Thank you very much. That's my favorite Celtic tune. It's called The Butterfly. I know I said jazz band's my first love, but Celtic, it's right there next to it. So that's The Butterfly. It's a slip jig, and we're next going to play a nice slow waltz called Neil Gow's Lament for the Death of His Second Wife. If that name is confusing, his first wife was his fiddle. So this is the death of the second wife. Thank you. Thank you very much. Our last two are combined into one. Excuse me, into one piece. So Mountain Road and Drowsy Maggie. This is our quick one. Hold on. So, before the strings go off the stage for the last time, this concert, I do want to introduce our string officers. So this year, our president was Marissa Epler. Our vice president was Matthew Bly. And our secretary was Michaela Chung. So this is the big change. The concert band is next. It's going to take us a couple minutes. So this is a good chance to stand up, stretch your legs before our last two groups. And again, thank you for coming out to such a wonderful night. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So, yeah, I was like, oh.
And here we are.
Yeah.
Welcome back, everybody. We're glad that you're still with us. I know it's getting a little bit colder out there, but what an exciting event this is, and we can't thank ArtsQuest enough for the opportunity to be able to perform in such a great venue, especially in a year like this. I'm Mike Moran. I'm the director of the Patriot Band and Orchestra, and due to COVID and the restrictions that we've had this year, we've had to divide the band into two groups this year. This is the A through L group band that has been rehearsing on Tuesdays and Thursdays. I left it up to the officers this year as far as the theme, if we wanted to do a theme this year, and both groups decided that they wanted to do movie music. So we hope that you're going to enjoy the next two portions of the A through L and the M through Z Patriot bands doing movie from the musics. Music from the movies. It's been a long week.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We have one more portion, one and a half more portions. The M through Z band will be next, so give us about 2 or 3 minutes to reset for them, and we'll continue on with the show. Thank you. Final selection for this portion. No movie music program would certainly be complete without doing some John Williams. We will be finishing up with episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, by John Williams. Star Wars. Thank you. We would now like to invite the Galatian Tours to join us for three combined numbers to the conclusion of the program. If I may take a moment, I know it's really, really late, and we certainly do applaud all of you for sticking through this wonderful program so late, and I know it's getting chilly out there, and many of you are sitting on the ground, but please, if bear with me while we thank a number of people that certainly we could not have put on this program. This is the first time since I've been at Freedom that we've done a full department spring concert, and I think that it's really turned out quite amazingly, considering what these students have gone through and what many of you have gone through in the last year and a half. So if you would please just bear with me for 5 minutes while we thank many people that helped contribute to tonight's program. First of all, they're very, very supportive of the arts, the Bethlehem Area School District Board of Directors, the Bethlehem Area School District Administration, Dr. Roy, our superintendent, the Freedom High School administration, Mr. Michael Laporta, our principal, who is retiring this year after 34 years in Bethlehem. Give a nice round of applause, please, for Mr. Laporta. The rest of the administrative team, Maureen Leeson, Mike DiBilio, William Cicchini, and Laurie Sage, who is going to become Freedom's newest principal starting this fall. The great custodial staff at Freedom High School, the Bethlehem Area School District Music Department. We are very lucky here at Freedom High School and over at Liberty High School to have such a great, talented group of teachers at all levels, from the elementary, the middle school, and the high school, that teach these students from little on how to sing well, how to play well, and how to be great people in general. The Bethlehem Area School District Music Department, let's hear it for them, please. From my end of it, the Freedom High School Band and Orchestra Parents Organization, who helped me so much throughout the year and every year, Jen Barron, our president. Did you already acknowledge? Okay, cool. Our parent volunteer ushers for this evening. Thank you from both organizations. The parents that helped out to usher, thank you so much. The BASD maintenance staff, who have been incredible, loading the instruments onto the truck, taking it back and forth between here and Freedom. Monday was our dress rehearsal. Tonight, our concert, they're going to be doing it again, and they've been incredible to work with, the maintenance staff at Bethlehem Area School District. Arts Quest, we could not have certainly, when we came up with the idea to do, where are we going to do the concert, because we can't do it inside this year. And Arts Quest just has been incredible to work with, specifically, glasses, specifically Susan Drexinger, Michael Lero, and Tina Renfro from Arts Quest. Let's give it up, please, for Arts Quest. Our seniors in all of the groups who have had such a devastating year, and I just want to say, you know, I know many programs lost a lot of students due to not knowing what was going to be happening in the music program. We've been so lucky here at Bethlehem to be able to keep making music throughout the year. They've worked with us. We've done what we needed to in spite of COVID. I know I should be wearing my mask right now. I'm going to get a letter from Dr. Roy tomorrow. I know it. These seniors have put up with so much for the last year and a half, and they stuck with it. They're there every day. Doesn't matter what I ask them, considering the roller coaster ride that these kids have been through. How about it? We're in the auditorium. We're not in the auditorium. We're up in the gym. Oh, we can go back to the auditorium. Oh, wait, no, we have to leave the auditorium again. And they're like, okay, here we go. We'll just do it again. Are we inside? Are we outside? Doesn't matter. And they just do it, and they put a smile on their face. Well, at least that I can see anyway. And they have just been awesome. And we tried to give our seniors the best possible finale to their senior year as we possibly could. And I hope that this was at least pretty decent for you. Our student leaders and the rest of our students that we get to work with day in and day out, and they've been incredible this year. Just absolutely wonderful to work with. So thank you to all of our students. For me, the band officers, President Judy Callow, Vice President Chris Noel, please stand, Secretary Jillian Weyerbach, and Treasurer Caitlin Marakovitz. Yes. And I know I've already mentioned that, but if we can have all of our seniors please stand and be recognized. Many of these students had the opportunity to bail out for this concert because of academics or whatever, but they are here. They have been here, and they will continue to be Freedom Patriots. So thank you to all of you seniors. Thank you. And finally, to all of you, moms, dads, friends of these wonderful students, families, you stuck with us. You knew that we were going to be making music in Bethlehem this year, despite everything else that was going on in the rest of the world, and we did it. And we want to thank all of you for your support, for being here tonight, for being with us throughout all of this madness that we've had to deal with for the last year and a half, and for the many years that you've been supporting the musical arts at Bethlehem Area School District. How about you guys give a nice round of applause for your parents? Did I get everybody? And, thank you very much. Tom Braun, who is the man behind everything that you see with Bethlehem online, the BASD channel, who's here streaming this concert tonight. Thank you, Tom Braun, for all you do for Bethlehem. Thank you very much. For those of you that have been coming out to our programs, especially the band programs, you know it would not be a Freedom High School band program without ending with our national march, the Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you. Mr. Lynn, you want to come out? All the students that are left, come on out. Be recognized one more time. Mr. Lynn, are you still here? Did you go home already? Oh, there you are. Thank you for coming out and attending this fantastic event. I think we could do this once every 4 years, maybe. But thank you, everybody. Enjoy the rest of this school year, and let's make it great. Good night, everyone. Thank you.